welcome. Scipio 2 here. Today, gonna do a little unboxing type deal of Magpul's bolt action magazine well and the PMAG 762 or PMAG 5762 as it is properly titled. You'll see before you Remington 700, my Hunter 700 stock and chassis. I've got video reviews on both of these, as well as the Timney trigger, the loophole scope, blah, blah, blah. If you're interested in all that, you can find them in my list of videos. But today we're going to be talking about this and what you get in the package. Obligatory Magpul sticker, of course. This is the instruction sheet. It's very simple and straightforward. Basically, it's a total of 8 steps. I'll toss that over there. Some packages for the plastics, and then you get the important parts. The new AICS pattern mag. It is a 5-shot limited capacity mag. There is a tang inside of it that you can clip and remove to make it a 6-shot. Let me see, I'll show you all that. Right here, if you can see, let me pinch that up. There's a slight crease or line in the mold. Snip that off right there, and you can actually have a 6-round capacity if state applicable laws apply. Basically, the mag is standard Magpul fare, the Magpul polymer, the web waffle design, the new M3 style indicators, yada yada yada. And it goes back together nice and simple, just like any other mag, or Magpul mag, I should say. And then I say that, and then the follower, or not the follower, but the lock plate sticks. Anyway, there's that. As a word of note, this little combo package is available $60-$70, basically. If you look around, you should find it in the neighborhood of $60-$70. An AICS pattern mag, doesn't matter if it's a 5-shot or a 10-shot, is going to run you at least that much. So you get the Magpul version of it for, basically the same price. But hey, bonus, they throw in a bottom metal adapter. That's a win all the way around. These mags by themselves, I think, are running about $30-$35. Don't quote me on that, I could be wrong, but I think they're $30-$35. And while they're not available yet, they will be soon in a 10-round capacity. Again, this is a 5-round capacity that can be modified to hold 6. State and applicable laws apply. But the key to it is the magazine adapter, or bottom metal. Bottom metal. It's not metal. I don't know that it's the usual, typical Magpul polymer. It might be. It feels denser than that. I don't know, I could be all kinds of wrong, but whatever. Anyway, it's all polymer Magpul stuff, except for the maglock, which is ambidextrous. You have a tang on either side. It is metal. It is heavily springed. It is pinned through and through. And it comes up and locks the mag at the back on this little foot right here. This is a direct fit for their Hunter 700 stock system. There's this adapter plate that is in the stock from the factory. You take this out and it fits right in just like it was absolutely meant to be there. This can be fitted and adapted to other stock systems, but understand there will be some inletting and so forth required, meaning you'll have to massage and remove material in this area here to allow it to fit properly and so forth. But anyway, this is what all comes in the package. It's, what can you say about Magpul stuff? Hasn't already been said, right? And I know I'm a fanboy and I'm biased, but it's, it's good, clean, smooth lines. Everything looks good. Everything feels good. Same with the mags, proven time and time again. However, I will say this. Out of the package, the mag to Magwell fit is very tight. And I know there's been a lot of talk about that. A lot of people are like, oh, it'll wear in and this, that, and the other. And, well, I don't know. I ain't got time for that. I think it was just too tight of a fit. And that's me personally. This may not be your experience. This may not be common. But what I did, and you may or may not be able to catch this on video, is I went in and sanded the insides of the Magwell adapter, the bottom metal, if you will. I just took me some 800 grit sandpaper, smoothed it out in here, smoothed it out on here, same here, not here, because this is the metal catch, but here, here, and here. Sand those out a little bit. Another thing I did, which I found simplifies the process, is I put more of an aggressive bevel on this front edge. These mags are ideally loaded similar to AK fashion. Stick the front in, push it up. That was, I don't want to say it was a pain in the ass, but it was what I felt, what I believed, more difficult than necessary. So by beveling that edge and clearancing yourself and just smoothing it up with, like I said, a little 800 grit sandpaper, nothing radical, nothing crazy, just smoothed it up, took off just the bare minimal of material, and now goes in easy peasy, nice and greasy. So bear that in mind if and when you go about doing this. So anyway, that's my initial thoughts. I'll be honest, I was a little disappointed to find out that because of this steep angle in the trigger guard, it will not directly fit the Timney flat blade trigger, which, if you've seen my other videos, you know that's what I've got. So, been debating whether I wanted to modify that trigger blade or the Magwell adapter. However, I can get in, remove some material from here. It really isn't going to take much, and it'll clearance. I'm not sure how I'm going to like the fit of it being that close to the rear of the trigger guard, but, you know, your options are limited, and we're just going to have to do it and see what happens. Obviously, I haven't done that yet. Wanted to make this a little unboxing package video, first thoughts kind of thing, impressions and all that. So that's where we're at. Stay tuned, though. Come back, because it won't be long, because you can see I've got it all laid out here, so you know what I'm about to get to work on, kids. Anywho, this has been Skippy02 with a little discussion and what's in the box type video of the Magpul 762 AC Magwell adapter for bolt action rifles. What a mouthful of a name. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Y'all take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and God bless.